Welcome to another edition of my Fireside Chat. Today I come to you to speak about a very important issue to those of us on university campuses, and that's dealing with our active and retired military men and women and our veterans. Currently at Delta State we have about 100 students who are using the GI Bill to pay for their tuition. We take pride in supporting our military and encouraging them to earn their degree, and they're just like other students on campus, but we honor them because they've served our country. In fact, we have a bronze tree-shaped plaque located in the atrium of Jobe Hall here on campus that has the names of our veterans, including alumni, faculty, staff, students, and friends of Delta State who have served in one of the other branches of the military. Today I have a very special guest with me, one of our most outstanding alums, who was our Outstanding Alumnus of the Year back in 2010 and is a member of the Delta State University Hall of Fame. General Thomas Moore, grew up in Scott, lives in Columbus now. His wife Leanne is with us as well, visiting on campus, and she's an alumna of Delta State, and we're very pleased to have him here. His career was marked with the distinguished service to the United States Marines. He's had several tours of duty abroad, served in Iraq, and has an amazing record of honors and a collection of personal declarations that would be too long for me to enumerate for you today. We're glad to have him here. He's worked with several aerospace companies and continues to work in the aerospace industry today as a consultant. Tom, welcome. We're glad to have you here. Tell us a little bit about your time at Delta State and what it meant to you.
It was a very interesting time. I came here and I did 4 years at Delta State. I did not get my degree. I was in a small class with Sammy Britt as one of my instructors, and he actually gave me some advice on what I should do since I was thinking about getting married at the time. So I changed my major and ended up going into the Marine Corps with 4 years at Delta State, mm-hmm. but I didn't have my degree. Mm-hmm. However, I had the opportunity through the Marine Corps to come back to Delta State, and I came back as a Marine captain, an aviator, and got my degree and finished in art here at Delta State.
Super.
I think this is a magnificent university. Our loyalty to this school is, as you well know, is tremendous, because not only did I meet my wife here, but my daughter went to Delta State University and she met her future husband, my son-in-law, and so they were both graduates of Delta State. It's been a university that's had a huge impact on the Moore family.
That's a great family story. Now, you have spent years in a military career with many steps in the leadership ladder. What memories do you have of Delta State and growing up in the Delta that may have led to that or helped you?
Well, from a leadership standpoint, I think this school has a tremendous amount to offer. And as I said before, the fact that classes are very small and you get one-on-one with your instructor, you're not lost in this school. You actually have someone that can touch you on a day-to-day basis and influence your life. And I think that's critical for somebody that's trying to get their degree, and this is a magnificent university to do that.
Well, thank you. What advice would you have for today's student? It's a different. We have a mix of traditional students and non-traditional students, veterans who have come back, they're on the GI Bill here. If you were able to go into the rooms and the apartments of our students and give them one piece of advice, or maybe two, what would they be?
I would say apply yourself as hard as you possibly can. I did not when I was initially here at Delta State. My father was probably didn't chastise me enough. I did when I came back, but it is crucial in today's society with the technology the way it is that you get a degree to be competitive, not only in the civilian market, but if you're going to be in the military.
All right.
We have some of the finest, the brightest young Americans that are serving in our military today, and you've got to be competitive. You need a college degree to do that. I think that Delta State provides a great opportunity for people to get that degree. And
you've had a chance to see the world in your career, had been deployed overseas, you've had many assignments that have taken you places, Hawaii, Iraq. As you've seen the world, as many of us who travel get a chance to see the United States from the outside, what's your view of America today?
I'll tell you, that's a great question, President LaForge. And I have been to 62 countries in my 36 years in the Marine Corps. What I've seen as I've traveled about the world is that almost everybody would like to come to one of the finest nations in the whole world. A land of opportunity, a land where you have freedom to get your education, freedom to practice your religion. I mean, you spent time in Washington, D.C. You know how it is. I mean, it is a magnificent, opportunistic government, and I think it's a government of opportunity, not opportunistic government. A government of opportunity, and I think our citizens are tremendously lucky to have been raised in the great nation of America.
Well, we appreciate your comments, and we appreciate your service to the United States and being here with us today. There are many programs that provide financial support to our active duty members in the military and our veterans who are interested in attending Delta State, or universities anywhere for that matter. Some of the programs include the Montgomery GI Bill, the Post 9/11 GI Bill, the REAP and the VEAP programs, and Top Up and others. For more information about those and other programs and resources, go online to www.benefits.va.gov and click on the Education and Training tab to the left of the page. Or you can contact our office on campus that deals with this in our registrar's office at 662-846-4040. Other events today between 11 and 1 on campus on the first floor of the Student Union, our Student Nurses Association is signing up people for the Mississippi Organ Recovery Agency Donors Challenge. It's an annual statewide outreach effort to increase awareness and outreach dealing with the need for organ and tissue donation on college campuses, while securing donor designations. Tomorrow from 7 to 9 p.m., the Mississippi Humanities Council has a Teach Award lecture. It's going to be held in the Wright Art Gallery, where you spent some time when you were here.
Right.
For more information, contact Dr. Paul Hankins at 662-846-4615. The Miss DSU pageant will be held this Thursday, the 23rd, at 7:30 p.m. in the BPAC. For more information for that event, call Linda Ross at 662-846-4669. And then on October 24th and 25th, the Archives Department will host the Mississippi Delta Chinese Heritage Museum. That's going to be a great homecoming sort of a program that's entitled Delta Chinese Reflections and Reunion, and will feature a day of lectures led by a number of scholars and visitors and those who have lived in the Delta. For more information, call our archives on campus at 662-846-4780. And finally, the Statesman football team will be traveling to Livingston, Alabama this weekend to play the University of West Alabama. 6 o'clock, October 25th. Tune in to GoStatesman.com to listen to the game and cheer on the green and white. Tom, thanks for joining me again for this issue of our great program that we've had so many months now, going back to when I first came to Delta State. We appreciate you being here. Hope that we'll see you next time on our Fireside Chat.
Go Statesman.
Thanks a lot.